There's a belief paradigm. Most of my Christian life, the focus on trying to live successful in the Christian life was focused upon behavior. Stop doing this, start doing this. That was basically, I would say, most of the sermons I've heard throughout my life was stop doing this and start doing this. I want to suggest to you that's got a real dismal track record. It hasn't worked well. But no one wants to say that. We keep promoting that one. Stop sinning and start doing this. Well, that sounds like Old Covenant, Old Testament teaching. Here's the law, now go do it. Let me ask you something. Did it work for them? No. As a matter of fact, when the law came, everybody died. Everybody died. It didn't accomplish righteousness. As a matter of fact, it condemned us all. But yet we keep falling back into that same paradigm. Mm-hmm. Stop doing this, start doing this.
Now, what some churches have eventually come to, and I feel this is at least in the right direction, but it's essentially the same problem. And they're not just coming out and saying, stop doing that bad behavior and start doing this good one. They see that doesn't work. And so what they've come to realize that the true problem, that we believe things that aren't true. We have impure faith. You know, I believe a lie and I don't yet believe the truth. That's my problem. And so that's a step in the right direction. But we inevitably, without a way of actually applying it, we end up in the same spot. So now instead of don't do that, do this, now it's don't believe that, believe this. How?
Yeah.
I want to. I don't want to believe what I believe and I do want to believe that. But how do I get there? Like, that's the piece that's been missing.
Pretty much anything we do to try harder to accomplish something will always result in failure. Did you get that one? Pretty much everything we try to do will ultimately result in failure, because that's not God's way.
Right.
The fruit of the Holy Spirit is not try harder or to try to fulfill the to-do list. Fruit of the Holy Spirit is transformation. God at work in me, me cooperating with God, outcome transformation. Now, back in the early years of this ministry, I used a phrase that the internet guys out there just nailed me to the wall, or at least they tried to. And that's when I used the phrase, and I called it maintenance-free victory. I don't use it much anymore, but I still believe it. And that's simply this, is that victory, that which is victory, doesn't require any effort. Now, it may require effort getting to a point of victory, but victory does not require effort. It is a state of being. And the question is, we say we have victory in Christ, which would be a state of being, then why are we still struggling? Why are we still fighting? Why are we still at battle? I think it's an important question. And part of our training, we'll try to answer that. Bad behavior, where we're at, focusing on, you know, the paradigm, the belief paradigm, focuses upon belief and not changing behavior or emotion. In transformation prayer ministry, when a person comes in with a behavior, if you're going to do authentic transformation prayer ministry in the session, then their behavior is not the focus. Bad behavior is a problem, but it is typically either an expression of or a solution to the negative emotion that one feels. Emotion is often perceived to be a problem when in fact it is a necessary part of the solution to the real problem, which is the belief. Emotion flows from belief, and transformation prayer ministry focuses on the belief and on the emotion. That's a paradigm shift for some folks. And it would have been for me 20 years ago, because I was a counselor helping people to diagnose their problems and come up with a solution. Today, I don't do that.
And to push the point even further, and the only reason why we focus on emotion is because it helps us identify and address belief. If it didn't, then it wouldn't have a part
right.
in the process.
Right.
And you'll see that with every part of the process. All of it relates to helping me uncover, identify, own what I believe, and then get in a position to receive truth. That's it. And so my goal is not to get you to somehow change what you're feeling, because it's sort of like if you step on a thorn, well, what good is it if I could help you feel better? That's not the problem. The problem is you have a thorn in your foot. Mm-hmm. That's where my focus is. And so the only purpose or point that pain has in the process is to help us locate where the thorn is. Okay?